There's been another attack. 20 people have been injured. 4 people are critical in this grenade explosion that has taken place in Srinagar. This is the third attack that we're looking at in the last 3 weeks.
On spot, यहाँ एक धमाका हुआ, तो जिसमें बहुत सारे लोग जख्मी हुए और एक बिहारी मुसलमान भाई हमारा वो शहीद हुआ, ऑन स्पॉट पे शहीद हुआ. हम तो देख रहे थे, वो खिलौना भेज रहा था, पता नहीं चला ये माहौल मौके पे बिगड़ गया. मार्केट पूरा खुला था, हर कोई काम कर रहा था, तो ये ऑन स्पॉट धमाका हुआ.
Our correspondent Mir Farid is getting us further inputs here. Mir, each time that you have an attack, this is the third in the past 3 weeks that we are reporting here. This is in the face of a communication clampdown, in the face of high security. What explains this? Is there any pattern that has come out so far?
Well, the only pattern, Seher, is that in Srinagar, these grenade attacks have in fact increased. And if you talk of this particular area, the Hari Singh High Street area, which is a very bustling market area, it has a lot of street vendors. And because of the present situation of the spontaneous shutdown and self-imposed shutdown that we're seeing in the Srinagar city, and we're seeing through the day shops are shut, so street vendors have increased. And the government has also given them the permission to be on the street so that some normalcy can be seen. These street vendors are all over in the Srinagar city, but especially this area has a lot of street vendors and obviously a lot of footfall of buyers, and a very bustling market. And right in the midst of this market, when it was the shopping was at its peak, this grenade has exploded, and it has caused massive injuries. 20 people, as you rightly said, have been injured. 4 are critical, and unconfirmed reports say that one of them is dead. He again was a street vendor, was selling toys there, a non-local. He may have been killed or he may have died in this attack. We're waiting for police confirmation on the same, and we've been told that since data is coming from other hospitals where injured have been shifted immediately after that, so the injury count could also increase. So that really is the latest. The police searching for clues, a lot of question marks, because this area is very highly secure, a lot of CCTV cameras, bunkers, patrol vehicles, but still this attack and these attacks are taking place. So obviously some sleeper cell, some module that has got activated, which organization, which outfit, we do not know, but a lot of unanswered questions as far as the security agencies are concerned, and they'll have to deliver in order to stop these people in their tracks, because these attacks can still happen and could be around the corner. Back to you.
Absolutely, still making the situation vulnerable on ground there. Mir, thanks for those inputs.